After some setbacks, Samsung decided to debut the Exynos 2500 chipset on their Galaxy Z Flip 7 phone, so I decided to compare it to the rest of the pack. We have four chipsets fabricated by TSMC, including Apple's A18 Pro, Snapdragon 8 Generation 3, 8 Elite, and 8 Elite Galaxy Edition. On the other hand, we have three chipsets fabricated by Samsung's foundry, the Exynos 2500, 2400, and Google's Tensor G4. If you don't know me, I am Mo. I have a PhD in the field of computer science and was part of teams designing chipsets specifically for AI and neural networks, so I have a good understanding of chipsets and their architecture. I picked the smaller version of the flagship phones, including the iPhone 16 Pro, S24 Snapdragon, Xiaomi 15, S25, Z Flip 7, S24 Exynos, and Pixel 9 Pro, since the Flip's heat dissipation signature is more similar to those than the larger phones due to the laws of thermodynamics. I'm going to run a series of benchmarks and real-life tests like CapCut, so we have a better understanding of the performance of the chipsets. In the first test, I ran the Geekbench test, which measures CPU performance. I should add a disclaimer that these phones have a different internal, so the chipset is not the only factor in their performance. The A18 Pro, both Snapdragon 8 Elite versions, and Exynos 2500 are all 3nm chipsets, while the rest are 4nm. These 3nm and 4nm labels don't exactly represent the physical size of the transistor gates. They are marketing terms referring to the chipset generation. The results are out, and the A18 Pro got the best single core score, followed by Snapdragon 8 Elite, Galaxy Edition, and the regular Snapdragon 8 Elite. The Exynos 2500 comes fourth. Also, at the end of the test, I realized it is better to swipe the position of the Exynos 2400 with the Tensor. Looking at the chart, the Exynos 2500 is very close to the Snapdragon 8 Elite in single-core performance, but it is significantly better than the Exynos 2400. For the multi-core score, the Snapdragon 8 Elite Galaxy Edition has the highest score, followed by the vanilla version, the A18 Pro, and then the Exynos 2500, which again is close to the Snapdragon 8 Elite and significantly better than the Exynos 2400. Also, if you're interested in the background images on the phones, I made them all using ChatLLM, the sponsor of today's video. ChatLLM can answer any question you ask, like what is the best chipset on the market and whether Exynos is as good as Snapdragon, and it gave me a perfect answer to this question. The reason the answer is so complete is that ChatLLM combines the best and latest AI models, including GPT 4.1 Mini, Cloud Sonnet 4, DeepSeek, Grok 3, ChatGPT 4 Mini, and many more. The Route LLM system used in ChatLLM simply picks the best model based on your prompts. With its humanized feature, the output doesn't sound AI-generated and can bypass AI detectors. You can also generate images and videos all in one platform. On top of that, if you're a coder like me, you can use their VS Code-based code editor. They also have Deep Agent, a powerful general agent that can build website, apps, AI agents, chatbots, complete research reports, nearly everything. What's amazing is that all of this is just $10 a month, far more affordable than paying for each AI tool separately. Visit chatllm.abacus.ai or click the link in the description to try it now. Thanks to ChatLLM for sponsoring this video. For the next test, I ran the Geekbench GPU test. Just note that this test is not comparable across platforms, meaning the Apple A18 Pro will get a totally different score due to the using different libraries, while we can compare the Android scores since they all use OpenCL. Ignoring Apple here, the result is very interesting. The Exynos 2500 got the highest score, followed by the Snapdragon 8 Elite Galaxy Edition, the Vanilla Edition, and then the Exynos 2400. It does seem that the Exynos variants do well in this specific benchmark, and they are better than their Snapdragon counterparts. And Tensor is just being Tensor here, not really competing. For the next test, I ran AnTuTu. AnTuTu is a very comprehensive benchmark that tests almost everything from CPU to GPU and UX. Here, we should also note that the score for the A18 Pro would not be comparable with the other Android phones, as the AnTuTu test is not cross-platform compatible and can only be compared within the same platform like Android or iOS. Putting the phones aside, the best score belongs to the Snapdragon 8 Vanilla version, followed by Snapdragon 8 Elite. The reason for this result is that the Xiaomi 15, the phone I used here, thermal throttles much later than the Galaxy S25. Therefore, you simply get better performance because the phone takes longer to throttle. The same happens for the Exynos 2500 and Flip 7. Flip phones throttles much faster because only the top part houses the components. Therefore, the score of Exynos 2500 here is lower than the Exynos 2400. So generally speaking, you should take this AnTuTu result with a grain of salt, since the heat dissipation and also the thermal throttling limit, which is more of a software limitation, varies between these phones. The only hard truth is that the Tensor G4 is not great. For the next test, I ran the wildlife stress test. This is a 20-minute loop that puts phones under heavy load, tests the thermals, and tries to simulate playing a heavy 3D game for an extended period of time. Also here, we can't really compare the iPhone since it caps performance at 60 frames per second, while the other phones let it go up to 120 frames per second. The Snapdragon 8 Elite did the best here, followed by the Snapdragon 8 Elite Vanilla version. Then, surprisingly, the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 came out ahead of the Exynos 2500, most likely due to the fact that flip phones throttle faster, followed by the Exynos 2400, and Tensor, as always, just gets the participation trophy. For the next test, I ran CapCut to export a video in 1080p. I know a lot of you want me to do these type of tests more than benchmarks, but real-world tests are not always representative. For example, the proper scientific method here would be to run multiple videos with different codecs and length on multiple editing applications. In benchmarking, we call this process batch testing. Exporting only one video isn't enough, even though it does give you a bit of an idea about the chipsets and phones. That's why I try to do more benchmarkings rather than creating my own benchmark. In this test, Apple's A18 Pro finished the task first. The Xiaomi 15 with the vanilla version of a Snapdragon 8 Elite surprisingly finished faster than the S25. What was even more surprising is that the Z Flip 7 with Exynos 2500 finished third, before the S25 with the Snapdragon 8 Elite Galaxy Edition even had a chance. Looking at the final results, the A18 Pro finished in 95 seconds and came first. The Exynos 2500 did a pretty decent job and got a great boost compared to the Exynos 2400. Overall, it does look like the Exynos 2500 is a bit of a mixed bag. It is an obvious improvement over the last generation Exynos, but it mostly lags behind the Snapdragon. I did exclude the test where the A18 Pro could not be compared, including AnTuTu, 3D Mark, and the Geekbench GPU test, and gave the most points to the chipset with a better result, while the last place would get 0 points. The final result is that the A18 Pro comes out on top, but both Snapdragon 8 Elite chipsets are pretty close. The Exynos 2500 is below them, but is still doing relatively well. And you'll never guess who comes last. Yes, Google's Tensor G4, and I'm absolutely shocked. I know some of you would also be interested in the battery results, but on purpose, I won't discuss it here since these phones put different amounts of horsepower into the race and comparing how much battery they consumed completely misses the point. I did do a real-life battery test on the Galaxy Z Flip 7 and compared it to the Galaxy S25 Ultra in a video you can watch next. Thanks for tuning into Tecmo, and I will see you in the next one.